Welcome to the video news of the week. Earlier this week, a groundbreaking was held at Indian Stream Health Center in Colebrook for a new 4,200 square foot expansion, as well as renovation at the medical center on Corliss Lane. The project will see an addition to the back of the health center, a new entranceway placed at the current main portion of the building, and a community room. The renovation will also allow for more exam rooms. For more on this story, see this week's Colebrook Chronicle. WMUR Television visited the area yesterday, filming a report on the Hotel That Never Was for a weather series to air on Channel 9 later this year. We accompanied the crew to the top of Lombard Hill in Colebrook to visit the foundation of the legendary hotel blown down in a storm in 1893.
Yeah, the series was just kind of a brainchild of mine early this year where I decided to take 20 towns kind of evenly spaced across the state and tried to find through local historical societies, local libraries, and a lot of local weather weenies like myself, an idea as to the biggest storm that community has ever had. Now, we've realized in this process that there's a lot of different towns that wanted, let's say, the Hurricane of 38, but there's also a lot of towns that have their own localized storm. And so it made for some very interesting stories and kind of backdrops to a lot of the different storms as we've been doing research. And yeah, it's been an amazing process and a lot of work between us as well as the historical societies and the libraries to get all the information together. There's a lot of really neat little stories about this, and that was the part that was kind of unexpected to me. Being the weather geek that I am, I was focused more on the weather part of it, but then I kind of have channeled my inner Fritz Weatherby to the point that now there's a lot of really cool stories that also go along with them. We'll start airing November 1st, and we'll go throughout the entire month till November 30th, minus Thanksgiving and the Friday. But yeah, we have 20 stories, 20 other side projects going along with it, and it's been a lot of fun to the point that I've already come up with another 20 towns that maybe I do in a couple of years.
It was a big weekend for Canaan and West Stewartstown. The Canaan Sugar on Snow event was held on Friday evening.
Gotta buy your lobster raffle ticket.
Also on Friday, the annual Stewartstown Day Queen coronation took place.
Amber Reynolds, she sold 800 buttons.
My baby. The following day, the Stewartstown Day parade and festivities were held.
Last Friday night, the Common in North Stratford had the rare treat of generating the music of a Dutch carousel organ brought to town as part of this summer's Fantastic Fridays series. Ed O'Brien of Easton, who owns the rolling musical contraption, spoke with us.
Coming around, I do a lot of nursing homes and places like that. And I belong to the American Carousel Organ Association, and we have about 470. We're trying for 500 members. We never made it yet. And not everybody owns one, but they we go on, have different rallies and so forth. But it seems like most of them are in the Midwest. I have to put it in the house in the winter, in the living room. It's like having an elephant in your living room. And I have to, and I do play it because you have to keep it active.
The basement of the Colebrook Library was a scene of multiple events on Tuesday afternoon. Children received awards for participating in the library's Make a Splash summer reading program. They also assisted with bagging food donated for the Food for Thought food pantry. Following cake and refreshments, the young, and young at heart, were treated to a magic show by Scott Jameson.
The Shaw Brothers came to Colebrook last Sunday for a concert which packed Trinity United Methodist Church in Colebrook. Twin troubadours Rick and Ron Shaw, accompanied by Taylor Whiteside and Woody Woodward, delighted the audience with a selection of the brothers' most memorable songs. The concert was sponsored by the Great North Woods Committee for the Arts.
I'd like to teach the world to sing. I'd like to build the world a home.
Sarah Cummings of Colebrook sent in this photo of the damage after recent rains to Roaring Brook Road in Colebrook. There's more on last week's storm damage to the Roaring Brook area in this week's Colebrook Chronicle. Look for a 30% chance of showers later today with a high of 70 and a low of 53. Saturday will be partly cloudy with a high of 73 and a low of 55, with only a 10% chance of rain. Rain moves back in on Sunday with scattered thunderstorms and a high reaching 78, and a low 58. In sports, the annual Canaan Men's Softball Tournament was held last weekend, in which 27 teams took part. On Saturday, the Buck Rub Pub Load Boys faced Ocean Glass in this clip. The tournament winner this year was the Mug, beating out Ocean Glass in the final on Sunday night. Thank you for watching the Video News of the Week.